How's it going? It is Charles Botenstein. We are going to be going over the April market report, market update, whatever you want to call it. I was completely wrong, so I'll be the first one to actually go out on a limb and take full accountability by telling you that I thought that the fall was going to carry over to the spring. I was wrong, which is actually in the benefit of all the buyers and sellers. So if you're actually looking to do either of those, it's actually kind of a good equilibrium. Slightly in the buyer's market, but not really. It's very hyper local, which we'll go over in a second. And I'll just go over why I was wrong. So in the fall, I actually said that because there was so much inventory, because there weren't enough buyers, because none of the buyers were pulling the trigger, that the market would spill over into the spring. So what happened from November, December, and January was homes sold well below market. Homes were rented out or homes were taken off the market. And because of that, we've entered a slight deficit in, and we'll talk about it. Queens is a little bit different because they have a lot of new construction. A lot of homes are coming onto the market. But for my sake is we received an offer on a place that we put back on the market. So we received one on Friday. We received one yesterday, and we're potentially going to receive another one. So myself, I'm very bullish. We're going to be going and we're actually filming a property tour today. We're filming a property tour on Wednesday. We're putting a slew of homes back on the market. We're going to have about six new ones. So if you guys are interested, obviously shoot me an email. Let's get right into it. So Manhattan price, and by the way, this is year over year. So Manhattan pricing dropped 4%. That's, you know, nothing new. 4% isn't really that bad because last year it was crazy on fire at this time. I was literally putting a home on the market, first open house in contract. Put a home on the market, first open house in contract. And then it started to slow because all of the buyer or all the sellers, they received this information and they're like, heck, I'm gonna try out the market. And then the inventory just skyrocketed. Homes that took longer than a month to sell, it took longer. So the median days on the market, that's the best way to put it. The median days on the market is 117 days. And according to my calculations, that is 4 months. That's a long time. Typically, a healthy marketplace would be around 3 months. So this is about a month longer. Sales inventory remained very high and it increased 12% year over year. I think there's a lot of people for tax reasons. There's a lot of people for election reasons that are actually selling this year. You know, and I'll go into that in the end because I went through 2015 with the last election and I'm going to be going through again unless something happens and I change industries and I become a, I don't know, door-to-door sales encyclopedia salesman, which is not going to happen. But I went through 2015 and I'm going to go through it again the election season. That's towards the end. But 11% of the homes in Manhattan saw a price cut. Nothing new there. Rents continued to increase 3%. Annually. So rents are crazy high right now. I usually have a reason, okay? Because what happens is as pricing starts going down in the sales market or pricing in the rental market starts going up, it kind of has an inverse, you know, just like if rents go up, people are like, well, if I'm paying so much money, I'm just gonna enter the sales market instead of throwing money away. Pricing started to go down, so most people should start entering and buying homes, but we're not seeing that because rents are continuing to go up. Brooklyn, let's move over to the borough of brotherly love. Pricing remained about the same, only a 0.6% increase. Again, Brooklyn was completely on fire. That was the borough that was literally just bringing up the rest of the city. Sales inventory increased a significant amount, 22%. That is a massive amount of new homes, 22%. We'll talk about Queens in a second, so don't get too bullish there, Brooklyn. Homes took 2 weeks longer to sell at 90 days. So you're looking at 90 days in Brooklyn, which is 3 months, and then 117 days, which is 4 months in Manhattan. Significant difference between Brooklyn, 3 months, and Manhattan, 4 months to sell. And there were actually the same amount of price cuts, 12% in Brooklyn. So the L train was one of the biggest reasons that a lot of people in North Brooklyn were looking to move back into Manhattan. So renting and pricing should have went down, which it wasn't. And then they obviously canceled the L-Train shutdown, which is a good thing because it would have created complete chaos, which there already is chaos on the L-Train. I lived there, just quick story. I lived in Stuytown. I also lived in the East Village, and I lived in Greenwich Village. The L-Train is the toughest train to get on in the morning. I don't care what anyone in Grand Central says about the 456, or anyone at Times Square trying to get on the 2-3 or Penn Station at the 2-3. The L train is a circus. It is a straight circus that needs to be a reality show. There needs to be hidden cameras. There needs to be just a no noise needed. Just film people trying to get onto the L train. So thank you, city, for not shutting down the L train. Rentals had a large, actually rentals were pretty much flat in Brooklyn, and they had actually a higher increase in concessions. Concessions is lower, say, security, we'll pay for your broker, 1 month free, that would be a concession. So they were actually down 10%. So when concessions are down, that means they have a very bullish marketplace on the rental side. We saw in Manhattan. Moving on to Queens, kind of that borough that people talk about. And nothing bad about Queens, of course. Besides that, you couldn't nail down the Amazon deal. Gosh, silliness. And we'll talk about why you're silly. Pricing growth continued to slow, or price growth, I should say, continued to slow, and it increased 4%. So it was extremely high. And the reason being is that if you go out to Queens, it looks like Miami. There are cranes everywhere. It's crazy how many new developments have went up there between rentals and sales. There is just full luxury service doorman buildings out there, and you have your choice. Okay, and I'll talk about why. So, and I think pricing will actually decrease the most in Queens because there's so much inventory, which we'll talk about. Actually, let's talk about it right now. Sales inventory increased 27%. 27%. There's 27% more homes on the market in Queens this year than there was last year. So expect that the continued price increases that Queens has seen in the last couple of years to continuously go down. Homes sold at a faster rate of 67 days. So if you consider it, Manhattan is actually the longest it takes to sell a home, which is 117 days. Brooklyn, it's 90 days. And Queens, it's only 67 days. So obviously, if you look at it, Manhattan has co-ops, so it takes a little bit longer. Brooklyn, a little co-op with homes and condos. Queens, it's mainly condos, except obviously when you start getting closer to the airports. The share price cuts increased 9%, so that means the amount of homes that are on the market, should we lower a price? That increased 9%. I see that figure actually going up. And rents steadily increased 2%. So Queens, obviously they've been very bullish over the last couple of years because, as I mentioned, there's a lot of new development. It's brought up the pricing, the rental, the sales market, everything. However, that's kind of flatlining as the amount of inventory comes on the market. So instead, I think there's 16, just in Queens, 1,600 new homes coming on the market. And by homes, I mean apartments or homes. And 1,600, that's a lot. You need 1,600 people, minimum, taking a very expensive rental in Queens or a very expensive sale in Queens. So in other words, and I say that because these are brand new buildings, okay? They're not asking, $2,000 for a studio. These are beautiful buildings with incredible amenities that you're buying it with no one that has ever lived in it ever at any time. So I, as I started the video, was completely wrong in the fall. I thought the fall market, which was the worst that I've experienced since 2009 when I started in real estate, would continue to the spring, this spring. I was wrong. So I'm glad I was wrong, actually, because we are putting a lot of homes on the market and representing the owners, we want to sell those homes. So if you are interested in any detail metrics, then shoot me an email, charles@bodenstein.com. And I'll just let you know, I would say, timing-wise, if you're looking to buy, obviously you really want to, dip your feet in the water now. Because you want to understand that what you are seeing right now is what you could afford. Because a lot of people, they say, I'm looking to buy. and your debt-to-income ratio or your post-closing liquidity or your credit, or you have to sell something or you're waiting for restricted stock or something like that to vest, obviously that's a little bit different, okay? When you're selling, I highly recommend that you put it on the market in the next 45 days. I'm gonna go visit another home of an owner. He's over in California tomorrow. I have a pitch on Thursday for someone that's actually overseas, and both of them are looking to list their home. I'm gonna tell them the exact same thing, which is now is the time to list, okay? You want all the people that received their bonuses, all the people that know where their kids are gonna be in the next school year, all the people that are looking for second homes, they know exactly what's going on in the next 3 weeks. This is the time to sell. I also went to a house completion or house construction completion party last night. It took a year to actually complete the apartment. The price is to be determined. I talked to the owner last night, and I think they want a little bit more than what I want to put on the market for. Go figure. But that's going to be a beautiful rental, and it is a gorgeous West Village condominium. We're going to put up for rent. We're not going to sell it, but that is something I'm very excited about. All that coming available. If you guys have any questions, charles@boneston.com. Have an amazing day. And as always, we're going to be coming to you live on Fridays with all of the news and celebrity news and just moment-to-moment updates. And obviously hear from my beautiful voice about what I think is going to be happening, honestly, in the real estate market. So any questions, charles@boneston.com. Have an amazing day. Talk to you guys.